Good evening, trustees and members of the community. Today is Administrative Professionals Day. So I know you all in the community and our board join me in recognizing and thanking our tremendous office professionals for their amazing contributions to our school community. Their work establishes the strong foundation in our organization, in our schools. They are often the first face that children see in the morning, and they certainly are the face that folks see when they have troubles. And so we appreciate their problem-solving abilities and their wonderful work in our schools. And just on behalf of the board and all of our staff, we want to reach out this evening and extend our deep appreciation to our office professionals. Some photos there of some of ours. The instructional team made a brunch this morning, so isn't that nice? Yeah, nice job of them. A group of Ann Arbor Public School middle school students participated recently in the first Lego League's robotic competition. Their team, which is named the Titanium Beast, won the regional competition and advanced to the state level and won first prize for global innovation with their project, the Be Alert Plus. The team will travel to Washington, D.C. in June for the national competition and will present their innovation to expert judges in Washington, D.C. So congrats to these great middle school students. Skyline's SkyWell Program, we have Skyline Principal here tonight, Mr. Corey McElmill. Their SkyWell Program, a student-led initiative aimed at improving student attitudes and actions regarding personal health and wellness. They just received an award and a $2,500 grant from SETSEG Foundation in partnership with the Michigan Association of School Boards. The grant will expand the SkyWell program. A basic factor in their selection is that SkyWell doesn't just teach students what choices they should make, it introduces wellness as a life skill. So it's really critically and fundamentally different, and we're so proud. Congratulations, Principal McElmill, and to your great team for that accomplishment. The Pioneer High School Corollaires, and last meeting, Trustee Gaynor shared about their presentation over at the UMS luncheon. Well, since that, they've been busy. They were selected as the top ensemble group at the state solo and ensemble competition. And as a result of that, they've been chosen then to perform at the Michigan Youth Arts Festival in May at Western Michigan University. This is the fourth time that the Corollaires have been selected to perform at this recital. And it is the sixth straight year that Pioneer Choirs will be represented at this prestigious event. And congrats to our Corollaires and Mr. Steve Lawrence, the choir director at Pioneer. Congrats, congrats. And do I see Mr. DeAngelis as the principal here tonight? Congrats to high school, to Pi High, it's Principal Tracy Lauder, if he's here or not. Okay. 15 Slauson students expanded their computer programming skills by working with 8 U of M students throughout this school year. They're called the Coding Club, and they meet after school once a week, and they really have learned how to program in Python, to write logic, true-false, and conditional statements, along with how to write in strings. They also demonstrated their knowledge at the Ann Arbor STEAM Expo. Students wrote programs in Python programming language to play Guess That Number. Diane Grant is their amazing teacher advisor. Congrats to those Slauson students. Saturday was a great day in Ann Arbor and a great day at Skyline High School as we celebrated the TEDxYouth Ann Arbor. You can see some of the photos here. I was able to watch some of it on remote live stream. I know it was just a tremendous day as local teens took to the stage to talk on subjects focused on sparking the change, breaking the silence, healing the divide, and aspiring to inspire. TEDxYouth at Ann Arbor strongly believes in the power of youth because they represent the future. I'm just so impressed. The same thing you said, Trustee Baskett, about these community high students with just the level of confidence and poise and really deep reflection and thought represented, tons of preparation represented in the TEDx talks. Two of our AAPS Project Lead the Way teachers, Sarah Szymanski from Carpenter and Kelly Newton at Eberwhite, were recently named 2017 Master Teacher by Project Lead the Way. As you recall, Project Lead the Way is a nationwide science, technology, engineering, and math program utilized by 40,000 schools. I want you to hear this data. There are over 20,000 school districts using Project Lead the Way across all 50 states. So approximately 40,000 teachers teach Project Lead the Way, and only 400 of 40,000 achieve the Master Teacher designation. Now, listen to that, to this. Of the 400 in the Ann Arbor Public Schools, we have five already in only the second year of our Project Lead the Way district-wide implementation. So Ms. Szymanski and Ms. Newton have been instrumental in bringing Project Lead the Way implementation to elementary schools, which is a prerequisite of the Master Teacher programming. We are so proud to have five of these tremendous teachers. Last Friday, I and the communications team, members of that team, had the great opportunity to attend the launch of the We Love Ann Arbor video. It's the We Love Ann Arbor 2.0 video in which I had the great opportunity to speak about the Ann Arbor Public Schools. So what a thrill and what a great opportunity. The video was commissioned by local realtor Rob Ewing. His son Steve Ewing is the videographer and does all of the photography and the editing. We've recently begun a collaboration with the We Love Ann Arbor website where we're sharing content across the website. Their reporter is actually covering a number of our sports events and they're posting their stories there. We're delighted because we don't always have enough coverage for all of those events that are going on in the AAPS. When you get ready, you may watch the video by going to the weloveannarbor.com. Or if you forget that, just simply Google We Love Ann Arbor. It's a little bit longer, so we're not going to play it for you tonight, but we're so proud of this, and it's such a great tribute to the Ann Arbor community and to the Ann Arbor Public Schools. Today, we received word of something, trustees, that we've been working on since the fall diligently, and that is that the rectangular rapid flash beacon, short, you know them by RRFBs, are installed at the pedestrian crosswalk at Fuller by Huron High School. Principal Schwamm is with us this evening. She and I had the opportunity to visit with City Council a while back, and we're just so grateful that they made adjustments in their budget. I really appreciate the work of City Manager Howard Lazarus and his team, Mayor Taylor, and City Council, and our Transportation Safety Committee for their efforts in implementing several additional pedestrian and traffic safety mechanisms around our schools, particularly secondary schools. So to all of our parents and those that might be watching remotely, just watch for those school zone areas, because not only is the sign and the signage and the markings, not only are those improving, but just a heads up, enforcement, the other E is also increasing. So we all need to be mindful of that, and it is a great day in Ann Arbor to get more of our safety mechanisms in place across the city to protect our children and citizens. This past Monday, I had the great opportunity to share the Sinking Fund campaign information with the Downtown Kiwanis Club there on the corner at Washington. It was such a great time with them. I want to thank Trustee Basquette and Mr. William Hampton that helped get that invitation. And we always love going to Kiwanis. Just great folks there and a lot of retired teachers and administrators. It was just great to see lots of those folks again. I want to thank the members of the AAEA. We received a letter, trustees, just in the last day or so, and I'll scan it and forward it to you. And they have expressed their sincere support for our sinking fund endeavor, and we deeply appreciate that endorsement. I also want to thank members of the Clegg community for attending the community forum last evening. Also, Trustee Kelly and Trustee Gaynor joined us as well. We had just a great meeting there with a tremendous turnout and a lot of students, about 20 students, I think, who were working on their government credit, and it was great to have them involved as well. We also, folks asked really good questions. This is a video that we're going to share even more of a little bit later on. Trustee Kelly and I were standing out front of the school, and we were just so delighted to see their latest resident of Clegg Middle, and that is the mother mallard duck, who has built a nest right by the door. And so if you haven't been over there, I was able to tweet that out this morning, that the mother mallard is doing what all the folks inside the school are doing today, and that is tending to their young. So it was a really truly great fun, and so we'll be watching for the baby ducks forthcoming. Tomorrow, April 27th, is our final community forum about the Sinking Fund Millage, and so we're looking forward to being over at Slauson Middle School. That's my neighborhood. I'll be happy to be there with our Slauson community tomorrow evening. Remember, that starts at 6:30, and everyone's welcome. If you're not able to get to the meeting, we'd just love for you to go on the website and see. We've got all the videos. It's really self-service on that website. You can be fully informed, even if you don't have time to get out to one of our many community meetings. So this Tuesday, May 2nd, is Election Day, and we always want to encourage everyone to vote. The polls are open from 7 a.m. to 8 p.m. in Ann Arbor, and we just appreciate your interest from the community and your engagement to vote. Thank you.